In this video, we're going to learn to use the export design tool, which is found here at the top of our workspace where it says export. And when I choose this option, it gives me the ability to direct connect to my embroidery machine. And this is going to be based upon the machine and the embroidery hoop that we would have selected during the setup of our embroidery design. And because I have the MC15000 selected currently for this design, then we could choose to Wi-Fi or direct, wirelessly connect to the embroidery machine, or we could choose to save the design onto a USB storage device and then take that to the embroidery machine. And so perhaps to get started, what I'll do is just go ahead and click on this new design that I created of this eagle and show if you wanted to save this embroidery design for your embroidery machine, you simply choose export. And in my case, I'm going to use a USB storage device, so I'll click on USB storage. And a window opens up which shows us the folders, or the drives, I guess, that are connected to our computer. And so we click on the drive, so there's my USB drive, it's called Alexar. And on that drive, there's a folder called EMBF, and that is the folder that we need to open up by double-clicking to save the embroidery design onto. And you see, the Janome machines look to the EMBF folder to find the embroidery designs. And I can choose to save it as a JEF file, a JEF plus, or a JPX. And when I say export, it saves the design onto that, specifically into the correct folder, onto my USB device, which is now ready to, detach from my computer and insert into my embroidery machine. And so you can choose. There is also, under our file drop-down menu, an option to export. And here you'll also find links to your embroidery machine or Wi-Fi or USB storage. And in this export tool, we'll find other options which may be available based upon what is currently used in our embroidery design. And what I mean by that is, right now you can see that I could also save the design to my Dropbox, or to SVG artwork, or to a quilting machine, or sometimes we'll find the option to cutters, based upon if there was any of the cutting technique that was used in our design. And so we'll look again at exporting other types of elements such as cutters in a subsequent video. But for today, we wanted to learn about how to export our designs to be used on our embroidery machine.